And today we have decided to finally listen to you. And why the fuck are you laughing? I'm gonna fucking punch you.
It takes you so long to get to the point, man.
Ah, you friend बहुत ज़्यादा बोल रहे हैं.
Let's do it again, like we are all friends. Okay, 1, 2, 3, go. Hold up. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Internet Said So, a show where we take random, interesting, shocking, weird, absurd facts, stats, trivia, and our personal stories, and we talk about it. And today's episode, we are going to be talking about Friends. And it's not Friends, the TV show, because we've already done it
one too many times. No, enough.
We're talking about friends, real or imaginary, that all of us may have. Oh. And we've also found facts, which is really weird. To find facts about Friends.
Guys, facts.
One fact is Friends are the family you choose. Do you guys agree?
Oh, that's a statement. It's not a fact.
It's a tautology.
It's a fact. Obviously, good friends.
Because one second, if friends are the family I choose, why is my family full of alcoholics?
But that's a good thing.
Why is my family you guys?
Yeah. Because Bhavat, you have no other friends.
Yeah. I have no other friends. This is true.
We are Zoom call attendees. Yeah. And we put it together and show it to our other friends.
The only reason we are here is because Baba has a premium Zoom account.
How quickly that changes the minute anybody else gets
a Yeah. account. Very, 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 very shallow. Yes. So, friends. How long have you guys had friends?
Oh, this is a fact. This is a legitimate fact. Even at a young age, this is a fact, babies as young as 9 months old can recognize friendship. They can recognize their friends even when they're 9 months old. They know that this is my friend if they have like other babies they meet.
Wow.
Oh, okay. They're hanging out in the ward. In the NICU and they're all like chilling.
अरे तेरा incubator कैसा है? मेरा अच्छा है, तेरा कैसा है? मस्त है. अरे डॉक्टर से बच के रहा, बहुत इंजेक्शन देता है.
Cannot believe Varun is hanging on his cell phone also. It is just weird.
Where? I didn't hang at all.
अरे you're hanging right now.
No, I'm not.
But it's not as bad as it used to be back in the old days.
It's fine. We can live with it.
We can back in the old days.
Okay.
And okay,
I have a question.
Handle each other's hanging, by the way. Okay.
Okay, I have a question. Okay.
Yeah.
Who is the? What is the longest friendship you've had? Like, do you have somebody from second standard, first standard, LKG?
Yeah.
Junior KG, like.
Mera longest friendship is 26 years actually.
Yeah.
26 years. So my friend Kushal and I, like, we know each other since the last 26 years. And we actually became really close friends since we were 12. So about 22, 24 years of friendship with him.
Wow.
So he's my oldest friend. To a point where I think, you know, once you're such close friends with somebody, right? Everybody thinks that you all are related. Like throughout school, college, even later, most people think that Kushal and I are friends. And we're also like same height, thoda same build. Or pura time saath mein reh rahe ke.
People think you're brother.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Yeah. They know we are friends, but they think we are brothers. That's how it
is. My friendship is, and I'm still friends with him, but he moved out of the country.
Because he couldn't handle you anymore.
He Canada. I actually Canada ka idea usse hai mereko ki Canada ka immigration law bolta hai ki mast hai, aaja aaja. So,
it's so funny. Other wants to relocate for one person. Who's not even going to marry him or anything.
It's your thought of that at one point. Ke zyada easy ho jayega if I want to just marry him. I met him, I think, 3 or 4 years old. And so it's 28 years, man. Damn, I've been friends with him.
Uska naam kya hai? I mean, I didn't tell my friend's name. My best friend's name is Kushal.
You said Kushal. You said Kushal.
Okay. Say it again, because he's my best friend, okay?
Yeah. My oldest friend's name is Ronil Talim.
Wow.
That's a made-up name, bro. Counter-Strike. Ronil Ladi. Kya na?
Ronil Talim. Talim.
Mahin Talim.
Talim. Talim.
Where did you meet him in school?
That is such a Maharashtrian name.
He was my neighbor. And that at 3, and then we went to the same nursery, same school, everything. So, both of them, school se bhi ghar wapas same floor pe rehte.
Hard.
I met three of my best friends in when I was 14 years ago. So 14. We were all in the same class. So.
अभी तू है ही 18 साल का ना गौतम तो दिल्ली
में या तो back when they were in their dad's ball sacks and I was in my dad's ball
and both your dads
you all met then
yeah it was a very weird situation involving all our fathers met in the 7th standard and so Abhishek Aman and Nihar and we've been friends.
How many of them are inspired, like are present? How many characteristics are present in your book?
Oh yeah, they're all present in Red Card. They're all present in Red Card.
Okay, I have another question. How many of them threw you the bachelor party that Adar and me had to bring?
Two of them threw me. They were there at the bachelor party. But I was in Kolkata, so he did. Okay.
Baba, tera, who's your oldest?
My oldest friend is Adam. Eve and Adam.
You're nice.
I like how now Bava's only started doing. Yeah, episode mein, I decided ki I won't make Bava's old jokes. We'll
I was
resisting. Jokes are getting stale. Yeah. So let it be. We won't do it. I mean, Bava.
No, but you know the funny thing is...
I was about to say Noah or koi. Like, no, Adam.
No. So because it's Bava, I thought Adam was just a Parsi guy.
I actually thought...
No,
even so, I thought the same.
So I think the oldest thing I have is a guy called Ronak. He's in New York. He's the guy who I stayed with when I went to New York as well. I met him in the 5th standard. So I was about 10. So that's a 29-year friendship.
But does he know he's your friend?
Yes. I stayed at his house.
Just to remind you.
Just because suddenly you're at somebody's house, you're not their friend. Sometimes
it's called Airbnb, bro. It's called Airbnb. Jaane ke end pe $1,000 liya hoga paise the, paise the, kya kar? So Ronak.
Ronak. I mean, I know him since I was in school. Since the 5th standard. So yeah, I mean, I would say he's up there, but. The person who I hang out with.
Stop interrupting Neville Kotok, please.
Sorry, okay. Man.
Already, he's having trouble because of this. Stop doing this to him.
That was one comment. Literally one comment. Everybody else is like, what?
No, but everybody's feeling it. Kotok, say sorry to Baba.
Yeah, right. My God. I am your friend.
Yeah.
Okay, carry on.
No, so but tell me one thing. Do you guys also do this where do you have more than one best friend?
Of course.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So earlier it used to be, nee, yeah, how can I call this one best friend? I already have a best friend. Mere paas abhi kuch 7-8 best friend hai. Aur uske baad kuch 10-15 close friend hai. Aur 25 very close friend. You know, it's
but for me the number it's the same circle, but it's all like 1-2-1. Like it's like the numbers are much smaller. Also, I can't make any more friends. So I'm
like Instagram has this feature close friends. How many of us actually care enough to add our close friends there? Like
I don't even use it.
I stopped using extra features in any app after like the
I have another app for close friends, it's called WhatsApp.
WhatsApp.
Yeah. I don't have to put it up.
One fun fact, which is that if you have been friends with anybody for longer than 7 years.
Yeah.
Chances are that you're going to be friends with them for life.
For life.
Yeah. Apparently a fact.
Yeah.
So
it's true. I think most of us have seen it happen in our life as well, right? Like, and also, you don't need, I don't think there's an age at which you can make a best friend or because there are times when, for example, Kushal is friends with me for what, 25 years now, right? But there's a whole bunch of others like Mihir, Chuchu, they, wo sabke bhi naam leke thak jaunga, but your voice come hai, but it's almost like you have the same amount of closeness or camaraderie, even though you've met them much later in life.
Yeah.
Like,
how
one of my,
did you meet them? What age did you meet them?
I met them at 16. Then there were two of my other close friends who I met when I was what, 25, 26.
But, okay, let me rephrase the question. What was the oldest year? Like, at what age did you meet your like last best friend?
29.
Yeah.
29.
Extrovert, social.
No, but that's my problem. I'm actually a very extroverted person. Yeah. Or mere ko dost banana and ek dost banana ek hota hai and to follow up. You know, it's very easy to just call somebody a friend and they are your. You'll call them once in a while or maybe even not.
Yeah.
But I actually am someone who consciously makes an effort. Like I will not be one of those ki usne mujhe phone nahi kiya to main bhi phone nahi karunga. Like
that's
I will...
how you make friends. That's exactly how you make
friends. No, actually that's how you retain friends is what you do after you've become friends, right? Because For me, I like calling them. I will message them. I will make plans with them. Even if they're all separate groups, I will try and devote as much time as I can to each side. Because I'm like that as a person.
Just never, like this podcast is Varun just calling us and saying, chalo, abhi karna chahiye, even though. This is what happened.
No, but you know, there is one actual fact that I found. Yeah. Okay, and that says, close friends share about 1% of their DNA, making them as close as genetically fourth cousins.
Huh. Wait,
I don't know how they are sharing this DNA.
Yeah, this doesn't quite at all.
It's under this awesome psychological facts about friendship. So close friends share 1% of their DNA, which is more than genetically fourth cousin jo hoga, usse zyada tere close friends nor as much. I don't know how maybe, they share DNA.
So that makes sense.
Maybe it is because we all, I'm assuming there is some part of the DNA is similar. Right.
I mean, they've not elaborated. They've just made a blanket statement. Okay.
By the way, this person said so, and we don't endorse anything except what the fucking internet says. So don't blame us.
Yeah. You may not be sharing a DNA, but you know, here's another thing. All friendships are not mutual. Only half of people we consider friends return the feelings.
Oh, that explains so much of my life.
Yeah.
No, but you know something, like I'll tell you one thing that I've realized, like for me, it's becoming very difficult now to make new friends. And I'm sure that's like an age, right? After which you can't make it, because it's like, there's just too much of backstory to tell them.
Yeah, right? Like you have to explain to them everything. Like, arey, ye pasand hai, ye khata hai, ye mera favorite color, hobby, blah, blah, blah.
You know, we've known
each other for what? 6, 7, 8 years now, and we are still telling each other our backstories.
Yeah, it's called the podcast. But the point is, you know what it feels like? Like, my old friends have seen, like, all my Marvel movies, right? From Iron Man till Endgame, they've seen everything.
Mm. Yeah.
Like, the new guys are coming in from the middle, and then have to, like, go, like, अच्छा तो ये कैरेक्टर ना पहले वहां था और फिर ये ऐसे हुआ है और फिर वो मूवी देखा तूने वो मूवी
बट यू नो आई डोंट ऑलवेज थिंक दैट
ही डजंट क्वालीफाई एज अ फ्रेंड ओके लाइक दैट्स नॉट पासर ऑफ एज अ फ्रेंड दैट यू
आई डोंट थिंक आई थिंक दैट दैट्स व्हाई द डिफरेंस इज स्लाइटली आई थिंक द न्यूअर बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स आर इन दैट पेरिफेरल सर्कल बिफोर दे एक्चुअली एंटर द फर्स्ट सर्कल यू ओनली एंटर द न्यूक्लियस if you've gone through a tragedy together or they've helped you or you've moved to another country and they're there, something like that. But I think the outer perimeter is just as close as the nucleus, except the nucleus has been with you longer.
Yeah.
So if you sort of...
This is a fact, according to University of Virginia.
It's a real university. Why the fuck did you have to do that?
Because
it's a fact in quotes.
Yeah, exactly.
I found it on Huffington Post. So I don't know. Huffington Post.
Virginia.
So scientists discovered that the brain activity of a person in danger is the same as when a friend is in danger. So the empathy level. So if you are in danger, the activity that you experience in your brain is the same as when you see a friend in danger.
So, possible, no? I mean, you're just as anxious or as stressful. Yeah. But the thing, Kautuk, about like the to continue my point in terms of the external group becomes close also because they end up knowing you, no? Like it's almost like, are Neville doesn't share food. Acha ye wo karega, ye karega. But just by like for example, when I joined Ogilvy, okay, it's been about 6 years since I've been there now. Okay, about almost 6 years. Okay, but there are a bunch of people who are there, they know that he won't share his dabba. Like, I have friends there who are legitimate friends, right? Like, and they're part of the thing. They've been through thick and thin with me. They've been through whatever. But are they in the nucleus? Maybe not. Yeah. But are they as close as the nucleus? The only difference is they've known me all. The nucleus has known me for 29 years. You
basically,
know?
Yeah. Just hanging around over time makes them more important, right?
That's yeah, but you know, that
I don't think it's important. I don't think it's important. I just think it's closer.
Yeah.
No, 100%. It's your conversations that will be different. The things that you all do will be different together. Because there's one thing where you say that if your friendship is really old, it's obviously bound to be tighter, closer, this, that. But one of these facts that I found online actually says that the friendships that you make between the ages of 18 to 26 are usually the more robust, long-lasting ones.
Because you know by that time, I guess, like the kind of people.
No, because you also grow up, right? Because it's bachpan mein.
18 to 26 is really when you're going through a lot of life stages, right? You're going through a lot of life stages. You're passing out of college. You're going to move into another city or another home. You're getting married, possibly. You're meeting the love of your life. There's several possibilities. You're quitting your first job, moving into your second job. You're figuring out, you're getting fired. Like tragedies are also happening. Those kind of things are between 18 to 26. And so, like, that's really formative friendship.
100%.
The lockdown, especially, like just going to the office friends, like people who were friends in office, the lockdown has really affected those friendships more, I think. Because the people who were just talking to each other in the office and never called each other otherwise. Like, abhi un log ka kya ho raha hai? It's just...
Abhi wo log Zoom call pe baat karte hai, jaise main roz... 12
No, but I'll tell you one thing. Honestly, don't you think that lockdown has made your friendships like closer? Because ever since it began, like my love for my friends has gone off the roof.
Yeah.
Bro, because even when we're shooting the podcast, like the four of us, for example, right? We're shooting the podcast, but many a times, 45 minutes before or 45 minutes after, we're still
yesterday
chatting.
We were on it for 3.5 hours.
Yeah. You know, and that's also important, right? Because see, it's very clear that the reason our podcast works largely, or we've been able to do so many episodes of it without losing the freshness. Yes, that of course, that's first. But I think it's the friendship that the four of us share, right? Yeah. Because it translates into the work that you do. And we were talking about this yesterday, right? It's, I don't have to think twice before doing a joke for you to understand. Like, I know I will say it something in a certain way, and boom, all three of you know exactly why I'm saying this, what I'm saying, what is the reason, and your retort back to us. Which is why when fans comment and say, oh, you know, y'all are saying this, y'all are not letting other talk, he's feeling bad, or Kautuk is ragging Neville. Because if they actually saw the non-podcast conversation, they'd realize that that's who we are. In fact, that's who we are.
Even if they saw that I was living inside Neville's house, they would.
By the way, Kautuk
is staying in. Neville is Kautuk's landlord, so I don't think Kautuk can get Neville screwing Neville to that degree.
By the way, guys, if y'all are not, y'all should get on the bandwagon of making more friends, because according to this article I found, it says people live 22% longer if they have an extensive network of friends. So,
Varun will die at 600. And I will die tomorrow.
This
is by
no, but you know, Varun, you were talking about camaraderie amongst us, and the way you set it up and all, it's perfect. Because if you look at us when we used to do improv, there was some weird like element where we knew the joke that could be set up three lines earlier. Simply because we knew each other so well that you would just field it. And the most I've seen it happen between, say, a Bridge and Adar, who were great actors, and then you and Adar. Where just the ability of other playing dumb by virtue of being dumb would just be able to set up something for Varun to knock it out of the park, right?
Or the fact 100%.
That Adar would make me, because I'm not an actor at all, but Adar playing dumb to make
Malabar
me angry.
Malabar Cadillac.
But Adar playing dumb to make me angry would sort of genuinely help my character.
Dude, there were times when we were doing the improv show where while we are on stage, we know that for somebody who's not a part of a friend circle, they might not get what we're trying to do. But they would still be on board because they see us having fun on stage. You know, I think which is very important. Like, it just helps you bring out your own voice by having a collective voice. You know what I mean? Like,
I know for a fact ke, like Neville ka kya, if you get him angry enough, he will rant, and then you can like make him like laugh. The audience will laugh. With Varun kya hota tha? Bridge had this point of noticing inconsistencies in the scene. So he would just keep bringing. So I would do the scenes. I would do a lot of continuity errors. I would forget names on purpose because I know Bridge will point them out, and then they become funny. With Varun, if you don't do a punchline for 30 seconds, Varun
gets antsy.
Varun
panics and then goes into a punchline, like, and then punchlines without any context. He's just randomly ranting punchlines at one point. So no things like how to trigger the other person on stage and off at times. And okay, this is another thing, because you said people live longer with friends. Women with breast cancer, and this is just a fact, not verified, but
breast cancer and women are not friends.
Yeah.
Oh. Women with breast cancer who don't have a network of friends are twice as likely to die of the disease and 66% more likely to die of any cause than women who maintain strong friendships.
But so, love, that's true for any,
yeah, it can
for be. Any disease, yeah. Any so ailment, that, right?
That's what I have a problem with this fact, because they said breast cancer and then they said, and
no, I think it's because, also. No, I think it's because of the 66%, because of the statistic. Thing that they needed to get on board, because if you have any, that's what support groups are, whether it's alcoholics, whether it's getting, whether it's cancer patients, whether it's therapy, whether it's whatever, support groups are based on reaching out to friends, and you don't even have to be friends, you just have to have gone through the same experience. That's what a support group is
like. Yeah. So you know, the thing is, this applies 100%. When you have an illness, you should have friends and it'll help you. Unless your friends are immature guys, okay? In which case, like, they will find out. Yeah, they'll find out what is wrong. COVID. Oh, yeah, that too. But like, for example, like, you know, I did part of my schooling in a boys' school, St. Mary's, and over there, like, for example, if you got a cut on your arm or something like that, right, or like your knee got scraped or something, people, your friends would literally be like, "Kya ho gaya tereko? Kahan laga? Kahan laga?" And then they would fucking hit it. Lag raha hai kya tereko?
No, and I think that is constant across friends around the globe. Like, yeah. Doing this, or for example, when you were, say, younger, right, and your parents called, mom called, dad called, you answer the phone, your friends will always say shit like, "Hey, nanga kyun ghum raha hai? Hey, daru niche rakhte hai tere girlfriend." You know, like,
Varun, now you're getting into Kautuk stand-up comedy, okay?
Yeah, this is Kautuk stand-up. Please
watch. Oh, yeah, shit, sorry, I don't watch your stand-up. Cut. Now I know why y'all were doing it.
Yeah.
No, but so, you know, people, so here's the thing, like, people who don't have friends, okay, not having friends is as bad for your health as being a smoker or an alcoholic. Wow. There's no percentage, but just not having, it's just not having friends.
Unless your friends are alcoholics, then it's just wrong for both of you. Then the double, triple.
It cancels it out.
Yeah.
It completely cancels it out.
No, but talking about friends, do you all remember?
Unless, I mean, obviously, you have, we have like a drink with and smoke with, then you're anyway dying at the same time.
Yeah, but then the fact that you have friends crosses out, because then you will live longer.
You guys are lagging or what? I literally said that like 10 seconds ago.
Oh, we're lagging.
No, but tell me one thing. Like, obviously, we'll have a gazillion stories, but do you all remember one thing where you're like, "Shit, I'm so glad I have a good support network of friends. Like, I'm so thankful to my friends, or a friend, yes, or a group of friends."
Yes.
So, ek kuch incident.
I have a moment.
No, February. Sorry, Gautam. Continue.
I was saying, I have a moment where I thought the opposite, and that moment was my bachelor party.
but that being said, Kautuk, your other friends, Neville and other, still tried to make it something by getting chicken.
Yeah, but we didn't go because they told us, "Don't come, it's not worth it."
Thanks, Chaldi.
But bro, hum log char baar
phone kiya, koshish kiya,
bola ki bro hum log aaye, he's like, "Hey, chhod yaar, pura din main idhar atka hai," so it's pointless.
God,
so it's fine. Yeah. But yeah, to answer your question, Varun, and I want to go first because it's genuinely really really important. February 10th 2016, dude, mom's death. I mean, to me, that whole patch, when mom was in the hospital, there was work that was being extremely supportive. 45 days I have spent in Leelavati Hospital, dude, and my work didn't say anything. They didn't say anything. Like, I was, whatever I could do from work, I was doing from whatever I could do from the hospital.
Yeah, your friends with Ogilvy. Nice to meet you.
and then I'm saying, after that, like, just going through therapy, realizing a lot of things about myself, trying to become a better person. There have been a close-knit set of friends that have actually pulled me out of the gutter and helped me get through it.
Yeah.
And I'm truly grateful. Till then, it didn't, and they've stuck around with me. And you guys also, when mom passed, like, y'all were there in a heartbeat. There was no thinking. I mean, even Karan was there right then. Like, he was there in a heartbeat at that point, right? And like, everybody just thinks. So to me, for sure, and there's so many of these instances that are there across the board. Yeah.
So for me, obviously, there are a lot of times when there's been a there's been a problem in your crisis, somebody's death or whatever, where friends have come. But in fact, I owe a large part of the reason why I'm a comedian or I'm doing whatever I am to my friends.
Yeah.
Because my, like, the formative years, age 18 to 23, till the first time I went up on stage to do stand-up at Amateur Night.
You need to plus
the
one,
only,
no?
The only thing I was doing was, like, my friends and I would sit around and then we would, like, I would be the joker in the group, right? Arey, joke mar raha hai, funny kar raha hai, ye, wo, wo. But when it actually came to me telling them, I said, guys, you know, there's this open mic happening. What do you think I should do? All these fuckers were like, ja, tu ja. Hum log, wo, teko, pata, kitne log aaye the, wo first open mic when I went with 26 people.
Yeah, that's how you kept winning, by the way.
That's how I won.
Yeah, of course. Of course.
26 people.
One of the times that Kautuk also has another story where he wished that he didn't have friends. Because Varun.
No, but hey, but Kautuk go alag tha. ये मैं amateur night बोल रहा हूँ the first time okay वेब जब मैं और बुल्ला जीते
थे तेरा cafe Goa पे भी बहुत दोस्त लोग आता था dude
नहीं नहीं वो मैं friendly है इसलिए क्योंकि वो आते नहीं थे मेरे लिए आते नहीं थे but like for that specific day I remember because you're obviously nervous right गान तो फटेगा क्योंकि पहले बार जा रहा है stage पे there's 300 people in the crowd I don't know anybody but to see 26 friends sort of spread around when you go on stage अंदर से तो shiver हो रहा है डर लग रहा है ये वो and you see them सडनली ना ऊपर जाके इसे छाती चौड़ा हो गया और किल कर दिया यू नो एंड आई विल फॉरएवर बी इंडेबटेड टू दोस 26 पीपल हु केम बिकॉज़ नॉट ओनली ऑन दैट नाइट दे वर दे बीन सपोर्टिंग मी टू परस्यू दिस फॉर इयर्स बिफोर दैट सो फॉर मी इट वाज दैट मोमेंट
आई एक्चुअली रिमेंबर गोइंग लाइक आई प्रेफर इम्प्रोव एंड थिएटर एंड एवरीथिंग एंड Varun was the guy who asked me to write my first song. Varun was like, ek gana likh aur mere liye aise open kar and give it one last shot. And I was about to quit stand up. And that's when I wrote.
Varun, yeah, kya chutiya hai tu, bro?
And I actually went back and wrote like 5-6 songs back to back. And then it was like, okay, this is how I prefer writing. This is how I.
Hey, love you, yaar. Love you, yaar. Ha, Kautuk.
I've had like a bunch of times, man. Like my friends have saved my life and changed my life, like both. So I had one of the earliest times I remember is in the 10th standard. I'd reached this point where, like, you know, you go through a lot of shit as a teenager, and I'd reached this point where I was very, like, low and done. And it was my best friend at the time who basically got me out of it. And he was like, you know, fuck it, doesn't matter. You know, get yourself up again. That was one of the times. Another time in BMM, I'd just gone through one of our, like, the horriblest breakup that I have gone through.
Hey, Siddhi.
So, and it was like, you know, you go through a terrible breakup, you start spiraling a little bit.
Yeah, for sure.
Your behavior starts becoming destructive and shit. Yeah. And then I remember I reached this point where I had to call a friend and he left his, college and everything. We went to in Churchgate, there was a 321 degrees, there was a bakery there, and we sat there, had a cake, and I was like, dude, my life is fucked right now, and we had we had that fucking cake, and at the end of that one slice of cake, things were better. Like nice. That's the thing friends are there for, you know. Like at your lowest point, you just need, you know. I always maintain this. I don't think, and it's true for, like they say this, right? The fair weather friend thing. You don't find out when who your real friends are until you have one shitty day and someone leaves their good day and gets
come, into your shitty day. Yeah, for sure.
That's what like friends are there for. To get into your shitty days.
100%. But ye to bahut achhi wali story ho gayi. Have you all ever had a falling out with a friend?
Oh, yeah.
I guess all four. What kind of a question is that to ask?
That's I think you guys are so late to react. It's not even funny.
No, but then it's probably because we didn't
at once we'll all anyway.
because we no, Varun, no, 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 in your case, bad. Varun, in your case, though, I mean, it genuinely
more so.
Like
yeah.
Way more
no,
so.
No, friend to friend rahega na, no matter what happens. Like whether you've had a falling out, you all don't talk anymore. That doesn't change the friendship you all shared. whoever the person is, whatever may have happened. And I'm not talking about SNG, I'm talking about general, because there's so many other friends I've had. Many of them I don't talk to anymore.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
It just happened. Like this example I'll actually have to give, because I'm sure a lot of people have faced this. We have a really close friend, okay? And from my circle of friends since we were 16 years old. 3 years ago, dude just decides to go MIA. Doesn't return calls, doesn't answer calls, no reply to text messages, randomly will call after, not even call, like will message 4 months later or whatever. And this is somebody I have, other you to know him also. Uh-huh. This is somebody I've been close to a point where chilling every day. हमने अपना सब गलत काम पहले बार साथ में किया है. If no matter what day, what time, what situation, एक फोन लिया, we would meet. And now this person who is that important a part of your life, as you are of theirs, decides to one day just get up and bounce.
Mm.
Okay, I don't want to get into the reason, but I'm telling you. And then slowly it became so weird. We're like, अच्छा चल, he'll come around. क्या हुआ? Did we fuck up? Did we say something wrong? What is the issue? What is the problem? You know, you keep sort of thinking. You know when this was? This was 2016. This was 2016. After that, he has now technically become our shadi friend. So now, every time there is a wedding in our group or our extended group, that's the only time we see him. We don't see him otherwise.
But here's my question. Here's my question about that friend. Are you able to pick up from where you left off?
Yes. In terms of conversation? That's what I was getting to. Because we don't meet anymore as much as we used to. In fact, not at all. But all the 3-4 weddings in the last 4 years that have happened, and he's been there for it, because we usually room together at that shadi, you know, if Nikki does not there. So it's him and I would room together, and it was the same. Our conversations are the same. Our jokes are the same. It does not, and which is why I know that, okay, you know what? It's fine. You just sort of let it be, because when things need to change, if at all, they will change. If they don't, it's fine. Because what you share with this person is unbreakable.
But you know what I feel about, like, you know, so a lot of people have a friend who they can pick off with where they left off. You know, okay. You know, when I talk to them on the phone 6 months later, it's still the same.
Yeah. Same. Right? Yeah.
But I feel like the thing with that is that friends freeze you at the age you knew them. Right. So if you knew them at whatever 26 and then they've disappeared or whatever the fuck, then you are that 26-year-old with them. Therefore, there is still stuff to talk about. Like you become that 26-year-old. Mm. The thing is that you need to be like your friends. You need to be in contact with your friends, or you need to meet them often enough so that they're updated on your life and you can grow with them rather than.
Absolutely.
So, you know, so here's the thing that differs. I mean, you all won't be surprised that differs about me. I am pretty much like, I just blend into whatever circumstance I'm in at whatever point I am in.
Yeah.
Right. So, and I'm terrible with this whole like keeping in touch with my friends and things like that, which only I'm the ones who are really close to me know this. So if they want to call me, I hate people who call me and start off with like, hey, how are you? It's been so long. You know, this, that, and then they'll go into
okay, Baba. So I just today to ask what time you're going to send us. I was just being nice.
Anybody who starts, like, my friends basically will pick up the phone. Literally, people who are really close to me will pick up and say, acha, listen, wo jo ye, acha, ye kaam kar de. Acha, sun, kaisa hai? Okay, bye. Like, literally,
always.
And I'm that kind of person with pretty much all my friends. Like, I'm not even. My best friend, I don't meet. We meet like whatever, once in 2-3 months or whatever.
That's the reason he's your best friend, because he doesn't see you that often.
So to me, I'm a very different type of person, unlike Varun. Like Varun will stay in touch. He will put himself out there and like, you know, ye chala jayenge out karta ye wo.
The thing that Baba was saying about, like, you're a different person in different circumstances, right?
Yeah.
And the thing with me is,
I'm not a different person. I just, there's a collective of friends that I have at office, I have at this, I have at that, I have that.
Correct.
I'm
correct.
Not going to go out of like and
okay,
say.
Okay, so
hey,
I'll tell you the kind of person I am. Okay, I never wanted my different groups of friends to meet. I never wanted it because
ever.
I am genuinely different people with those people. So yeah, like yeah. I'll have to give an Oscar winning performance if they all come together.
Yeah.
I try to figure out my different personalities because like,
but I think, you know, I think that used to happen earlier because I am somebody, as much as I don't want different groups to join, I was also the person who would be like, acha, I know this person since school. Now I'm going to make him meet my friends I made in college. And now we are a big group. So same thing happened with Kushal. Now Kushal and I
were the glue that held the group together.
Yeah. No, not. Hey, it's an inside joke. Everybody watching all won't get it, but we get it. So with me, what happened is he was my friend since school and he's a close friend. And I'm no different with him than with anybody else. So when I went to college and I made my other circle of friends, I got him introduced. And now that group is my basic nucleus core group. Which has two people from school, rest from college. Then it came to another point where degree college mein alag dost bana.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So now Sanya, Umna and all, they are my degree college type ke, wo time ke friend, right? So now these people also know them and are also close to them. So earlier when I was younger, I wouldn't like them to mix. But now as you grow older,
I think you automatically want the
similar type of people from different groups to still sort of gel. Because after a point, you also want everybody to hang out together.
No, and also your personality solidifies, right? You become one person rather than
But which is what's great, where I have these guys who have stuck with me for so long because they're like, "Ba, aisa hi hai," and I love it. Like there is a comfort in that knowledge.
Yeah,
of this is what to expect, and this is what.
Alag-alag group of friends. Did you guys ever have the struggle of having separate birthdays? Okay, there was a point where I don't want these groups of friends to meet. So, ek birthday party alag se organize hoga, dusra birthday party alag.
Nahi, nahi.
Then you got.
Itne paise hai kya tere paas alag-alag?
Nahi, but paise to utne hi dene na. Agar tere ko 20 friends ko treat karna hai, to pehle tu 10 ko karega, baad mein 10 ko karega. Paise to utne kharche ho rahe.
But I understand what Adnan is saying. Like I would go out of my way to not let. You know, I used to have this joke where it should be like, I had school friends and building friends.
Yeah.
Then tuition friends, no, cricket friends, gym friends.
And my building friends couldn't believe that I like had school friends. And my school friends couldn't believe I lived in a building.
So, tera aise thana friends, lower barrel friends. So,
I made all my friends meet because I was too like on a birthday because I was too lazy to organize two birthdays. I was like, now I'm old, I don't care.
Yeah, yes, you can't organize two birthdays. Who the fuck is doing that? No, speaking of building friends,
I will still do two parties with the same amount of friends. मतलब party तो दो करनी है भाई.
The my speaking of building friends and my building friends who are also very close. Like I'm very close to two of them. Like I've known them since I was in the 7th standard. So 2 years after Ronak, but I've known them just as long, and pretty much anybody who knew me pre 18 or pre 21 actually can't believe that I am not lying in a rehabilitation center, or I have not died in a gutter, or I have not become an alcoholic.
That escalated very quickly.
Wow.
You need to see the trailer of Malabar Cadillac to just realize exactly what Baba is saying is true. Like, the guy is a different dude.
So, the reason for that is, everybody used to tell me this thing, and Kautuk, you should be very careful when I say this. Everybody used to say that you have anxiety, and everybody just gave me this gyan of channel. Channel your anxiety, okay?
Yeah.
It's a channel your anxiety. I never knew what that really meant. And so, literally, if you ask my friends, they're all surprised because I was bullied. I was not popular. I was like chipku and chepu. I was like a nerd. I was everything that you didn't, like nobody would. Nothing has changed.
Cool.
But like I couldn't take a joke on myself. So nothing has changed. Yeah. But
it's okay. Don't worry. We'll tell Kautuk not to make any joke. Kautuk,
please. Wow, because Baba can't make any joke.
Baba Budde, kisne start kiya? Baba Budde.
Baba ne start kiya actually.
Baba Budde.
If Baba Budde,
Hashtag Baba Budde.
Baba Budde OP. So these guys have seen me go through that phase where I wasn't good at studies. I was not fantastic at sports except for badminton and cricket. But there also I was not fantastic. I was good.
Baba, ek subtle gusse. I wasn't good at sports.
But I wasn't. So, plus, मेरे को drawing नहीं आता है, मेरे को singing नहीं आता है. तो ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है मेरे पास talent. So they were all sure that I was going to, but they would all like, you know, take me along. मतलब ऐसा चल हम लोग तेरे को Chinese खिलाते हैं. All of those situations would sort of happen.
If you just want us to take you for Chinese, just ask. कितना लंबा चौड़ा story बता दे जरा
दे. I have evolved, brother. I
don't. आजू वाले ठेले पे देखो खाने का.
हाँ अरे
I want rice खाना देखो.
Exactly. Other the number of times I've told Baba to join me.
Triple chase
Indian Chinese and the number of times Baba has insulted me.
Triple chase on chopper rice.
Chopper rice.
By the way,
toxic but okay, so there's toxic friendships are real when you end up having friends who are like are bullying you, are people who are around you. You are more likely to develop a chronic illness. So that is quite a legit fact.
Oh, 100%. Yeah, yeah. But you know, with when it comes to friends, right? The number of people you can handle in your social group. Okay, there is a study done, and the average is 150.
Oh, 150.
No, so these are not your best friends.
Yeah, yeah.
It's your extended social group.
That's still 149 people.
More than you, yeah.
So, but this
150, na bro? This 150 is called the Dunbar number. D-U-N-B-A-R. It's actually a thing. So, usme kya? To usme 150 log hote hain. And overall, it said in your lifetime, people make an average of 396 friends.
You're sure it's a Dunbar number and not Dunbus number?
That is the 396th one.
It is so true because you just have to have one wedding to realize this.
Yeah, you need to have one wedding to realize how many friends you don't want to be friends with.
Yeah,
so all the people who are Kautuk's friends who came to his wedding.
That includes us.
Yeah, but he's
still talking to us.
All you can handle. There's a bandwidth through your brain. And you
not just humans, animals, especially chimpanzees, baboons, horses, elephants, and dolphins can form lifelong friendships just like humans.
Yeah.
Ye animal friendship factor.
Mammal.
That's a factor. A lot of times, even with like a lot of animals, when they like mate also, they end up sticking to that mate for a very long time.
No,
like,
no, that's very few. That's penguins.
Horses, penguins.
Seahorse is also a hermaphrodite. So,
yeah.
Doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So, here's a fun fact. Okay. There is a scientific criteria for friendship. Okay, I'm just going to read the fact. Behavioral scientists and psychologists describe a close friendship as a relationship that involves a long-lasting bond of sacrifice and shared moments. Wow, surprising.
So I have no friends, that means. Technically.
And for those of you wondering, a true friend prioritizes your happiness, never asks you to put your friendship before your principles, and you miss them when they're gone. Like,
nice.
This is less a scientific study and more a poem written by a 14-year-old.
Yeah, it's like, it'll be really sad if a scientist dedicated 12 years of his life to this. It was like, to Corona.
This is like a 7th standard elocution thing.
My friend. Groups of friends, have you guys heard of this thing called the cheerleader effect?
Oh. Yeah. That you appear more attractive when you're in a group than when you're alone. Yeah,
so this why.
This again, guys, this is all explaining my life.
Yeah, so basically the cheerleader effect is the most attractive members of the group raise the overall perception of the group's attractiveness.
100%. This is.
And you know what's weird? It's sad that I'm reading this fact and they've actually uploaded a photo of six cheerleader girls and very clearly, four of them are much prettier than two.
Yeah, this is called a Tinder profile. I don't know if you know this.
Obvious, right? That's also obvious, no? Because there's also a positivity to a group that sort of makes it seem like it's more fun. So there's various levels that are working in your brain to make that person attractive.
It's basically, if you see a person in a group, you your brain basically goes like, oh, this person might be decent enough to have other people be around.
People, yeah, yeah.
It's not other people. It's to have other good-looking people around.
Wow. also, here's another cool one.
Yeah.
There's a reason why childhood friendships end. Okay, are you ready for this?
Yeah.
A long-term study by Florida Atlantic University recently demonstrated that early teenage friendships are almost always broken apart by dissimilarity.
Because of what?
Dissimilarity.
So okay. It causes conflict, it interferes with cooperative activity, shared pleasures, and it creates circumstances where one friend bears more costs, such as the friend who is less aggressive, or gets more benefits, such as the friend who has lower social status than the other. Dissimilarity disrupts relationship bonds. So, if you...
So, that's why uncles in the park are fighting now over BJP and Congress. It's like, that is where the friendship ends. 30 years of a friendship.
No, so exactly. So, if you make friendships too early and you're not the same person, eventually it's going to break up. Like, you need to make the same type of...
But tell me one thing. How much impact does or has it... what I'm talking about is political affiliations. For example, how much of an impact does that have or has had on the friendships that you all currently have?
I don't know how you guys have navigated this, but I have one friend who, like, and we've had a like very good friend, very nice guy, but we've had political, opposing political views.
Yeah. Right?
And the way I've dealt with it is that we don't talk about it.
What a guy way to deal with something, dude.
Yeah.
We don't talk about it. It's like...
In my group is the same thing because we are very, very, very clearly left मार लिया हम लोग ने ठीक है ऐसे political road पे left मार लिया left liberal वाला है एक है जो नहीं उसने left नहीं मारा उसने शायद right लिया ठीक है तो our way of dealing with it is on our group ना हम लोग सिर्फ jokes मारते हैं because he is also not the kind who will get like aisa kaisa bola iske bare mein you know he's not and we also know that he is not that extreme type like he feels the other side the one who you can't name
usne full right nahi mala sirf right lane mein chala raha
हाँ राइट लेन में चला रहा है मतलब वो ऐसे भी
एग्जिट से नहीं निकला है वो रैंप रैंप पे
वो जाके वो अभी राइट में जाके से त्रिशूल लेके नहीं आएगा तो वो वाला नहीं किया उसने
He hasn't parked the bus on the right.
Yeah, he hasn't. So that's how we have been. That's how we've been.
No, so I mean, what's great about it is I have a problem with fam that has this whole like Bhajpa affiliation or full right wing affiliation, right? There's a problem with friends. I think that it's just a like minded thing. I don't think I have friends who are fully right.
It came to a point where in the recent past, right, when with everything that was happening pre-COVID, I think that was a very good point for me to sort of see right from wrong.
It's a great barometer.
You know, because one is being affiliated and one is just being a bad human being.
Yes, ideology.
Where shit is going so bad. And you still have to lick it. Unlog bhi to aisa aisa aisa. Bhai, ye sab mat kar. I don't have time to deal with your bullshit. Main seedha block kar diya, bro. Do teen logo to maine block kar diya.
Bahut log ko.
Kyunki main Instagram pe ya Facebook pe kuch dal raha hu and they are replying with like bada paragraphs. But what about this? What about that? I said, bro, if you can't see the basic problem in the humanity of the issue at hand, then I'm sorry. I don't even want to friend to the nahi. They were more acquaintances, but like meet them at a party or. Extended friends, birthday scene, or whatever, right? I'm not going to end. I'm just not going to because mere mein hai nahi wo to go and explain to them. You know
what but that's right? Also the advantage of having a smaller set of friends where you get to choose the ones which are like minded and political discourse then work. Facebook algorithm picked it because mere ko malum hai ki kya aane wala hai.
No, so the thing with me has also been one of the ways to deal with it is also that. We see eye to eye on one fact, which is that most politicians are chutiyas.
Yeah.
Like, and that we can both agree on. Like, you know, wherever the debate goes, you know, when you boil it down to, okay, fine, you might have some different views, but you understand why the politics of it is chutiya.
Yeah.
And that's
fine. Yeah. So, let's agree to disagree, but we agree that they're chutiya.
Okay. I have a question, okay? which is that when did you become friends and like really close friends, and you could know that you could be friends with girls? At what age did that sort of work out for you guys? Because for me, it didn't happen till 16, 17 that I
quite late,
knew
quite
that
late.
It was possible.
To answer your question, the university, according to the University of Wisconsin, that answer is never.
Ek ladka aur ladki kabhi dost nahi.
Kabhi dost nahi ho sakte. According
to the University of Wisconsin. Karan Johar ne bola tha 1998 ki picture kuch kuch hota hai main. Aur mujhe lagta hai ki tum bahut chutiya cheez bol rahe ho. Kyunki mere paas bahut sari friends hai jo ladkiyan hai. Aur kuch problem nahi hai.
Okay, so basically according to the study conducted by the University of Wisconsin.
Was address the fact that Varun turned into
Shahrukh.
We just got brushed past the conversation like kuch
nahi. Because if you know Varun long enough, you know that he has bouts of Shahrukh Khan.
Yeah.
Hey, aise mat bolna.
For us, it's not kuch kuch hota hai. Aise kuch nahi hua hai. Chal, aage.
Carry on.
Hey, I love the sentence. Okay, I just need you guys to hear the sentence. Okay. So this is what they've written in a study. They've written, a male and female friendship is merely a facade, an elaborate dance covering up countless sexual impulses bubbling just beneath the surface.
Ye kon Freud ne likha
hai? Nahi,
Wisconsin ka Freud ne.
Apna ye kisne likhi thi? 50 Shades of Grey jisne likhi hai, usne likha hai.
नहीं मतलब इसका सैंपल साइज बहुत फक ऑल होगा. उसने अपने दो दोस्त को पूछा होगा, हे व्हाट डू यू फील अबाउट बीइंग फ्रेंड्स विद अ गर्ल. आई थिंक इट्स वेरी इजीली पॉसिबल. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दे आर रॉन्ग,
वो प्रोबेबली हैविंग सेक्स इन द बिहाइंड.
बट हाउ लेट, लाइक हाउ लेट और हाउ अर्ली वाज इट फॉर यू गाइस? बिकॉज़ माय तो बॉयज बोर्डिंग स्कूल, सो व्हेन आई केम हियर देयर वाज नो प्रॉब्लम. आई मीन वी वर फ्रेंड्स, बट आई डिडंट रियलाइज दैट यू कुड बी गुड फ्रेंड्स और क्लोज फ्रेंड्स एंड यू नो लाइक फुल्ली बी चिलर with like a girl for a very late, till very late in my life.
Yeah, yeah, 15, 16 for me also, like to that degree.
I was in a boys' school, right, growing up. So obviously the first close friends you had were all boys. And I remember I moved from Andheri East to Andheri West to this building that I lived for about 25 years. Correct. Of my...
In Andheri East, no one is friends with boys and girls.
With, like, no boys and girls are friends.
No.
So when I came here, in my building, I think that was the first time I saw not just boys playing together. There were also girls, and we were all playing badminton together, cycling together, this, that. So I think like good friends, like I started becoming good friends with girls at 12. Uske pe jhagda karte the. Uske pehle, ooh, cooties, you have cooties. Oh, ye, yuck, you're a girl, get out. You know, this is a boys game.
Rahul cheater nahi. Rahul cheater nahi.
Hey, mujhe cheater mat bula.
Anjali cheater nahi.
He is a cheater.
Hey, cheater nahi.
So, Gautam, what about you? Like, when did you realize that you could be like, you know, great friends with the opposite gender?
So, what happened with me was I had a group from school. And we were boys, girls. It was like 8 people, 4 boys, 4 girls. It was perfectly symmetrical. And it was like a teen movie, dude. he's the funny one. He's the this one.
Yeah.
Like that. So, and we all hung out and it was great. And that's when I realized. So, in school, just after school, like 16, 17.
Yeah.
But oddly
pretty,
enough.
Pretty late for all of us, actually.
Yeah, but you know something. Oddly enough, in my life, what's happened is that I don't have, my closest friends are all guy friends. Like, I don't have too many, like, you know, the first people I call would always be guy friends for some reason.
Oh, so, opposite for me.
But that's weird. Like, I have two really close girlfriends. Like, they're probably the two people I'd pick up the phone and call first. Include, yeah. I think I'll do a con call eventually.
So I think it's the same for me also. I think it's about two girls and two guys for me also. That like that close, that tight, that knit.
I think it's what needs to change fundamentally from a young age for a lot of boys is that the more you are exposed to girls and how to behave, etc., at a young age, right? It's
Don't make the gender a thing, it's not a thing.
Exactly. Yeah. Like the more you avoid this boy girl situation, the better you will grow up. Because I think a large part of how I behave with women, what I would think, say, do, it comes from obviously your mom, or if you have a sister at home, or your cousins, and then it's your girlfriends, right? If the way you are behaving with a girl,
thing is that,
if you behave a certain way with a girl, right, which is bad, the only way you'll realize it if you see your other girlfriends, if their boyfriends or some other guys behaving like that with them, and you'll be like, no, don't talk to that guy, don't be like this. If you don't want that guy to behave like that, why the fuck would you behave like that with your other girlfriend? You get what I mean? So I think it's very important to just diminish that and just get rid of that
line. And also from a maturity sense, no, women are a little more sensible. Right?
Like 100%. They just are. 100% they are more sensible.
So as a result, because they don't have games now where they hit each other on their balls and all. They don't do this stuff.
They don't do
it. So they don't have these games. So I'm saying because they're also more sensible, which is why they also get really frustrated with us really quickly, because we mature only after a tragedy. Like one big event has to happen in your life for you to actually be a mature guy. So they call out your bullshit pretty soon.
Yeah.
And they'll pretty much tell you to your face. Like your guy friends will sort of like say, "Arey, chalna, it's okay." But girls are not like that. And that, I think you need that in your life.
100%. 100%.
I think the girls who are my friends have actually helped me improve my relationship with my mother and my sister. Because family, you end up being like a little formal sometimes, which is weird. Why would, like, Indian family, I think that's why you're a little formal with your mom and sister. You wouldn't talk about your girlfriends with your mom and stuff like that. And
why?
You don't end up, it never ends up happening until a certain age. Until a certain age, like 18, 19, 20 ke pehle, you wouldn't really talk to your mom about the girls.
That,
no, 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 dude. What? I agree with other. I agree with
other. When I had my first breakup at 13, the first person I told this to was my mother.
Aray, but everyone's parents aren't like that. No, the general parents are very...
That's why you have 329 and friends and we are at 100.
70.
So generally the psyche of Indian parents is ki, oh, this is not the right age to talk about. Don't do this.
Padhai kar.
Okay.
Fair
enough.
Correct.
So FIBM khatam kar, FIBM.
Correct. And when you meet a girl like who is your close friend, she actually helps you open up to the fact that, oh, I can talk to my mom like this, I can talk to my sister like this about the same stuff. In fact, they encourage you to do that. So I think that has changed in my life because my best friend right now is a girl, and that has really changed the last 5-6 years.
I also don't know why Adar said right now.
Yeah. Because change ho gaya, I met her 7 years ago, 8 years ago. So that's when we actually began. Up till that point, it was some
statistic.
The thing I envy the most about just female friendships is the undying, unjustified, unbelievable amount of support they can give each other. Like it's just unbelievable, dude. Guy friendship do not have that. It doesn't exist.
Your friends will sell you out the second they get a chance.
Yeah,
your best friends will stab you in the back. Guy friends, dude. My first girlfriend, you know, once we broke up, who was she dating after me? Oh. My bad time ka best guy friend from the building. Harami, tu mere ko pehle bolta tha ki nahi bro, you should go after her, you should do it, I'll support you. Jaise breakup hua, pehle tu ghusa andar rakha, kabhi nahi.
Ye mera bhi hua tha. School mein cheat karke uske saath usko letter bheja tha usne. Bro, bhool gaya kya?
No, the point is that, like, you know, you'll see this best in birthdays. Like, female friendships, the girls will write each other these fucking long ass novels. Happy birthday, you're the most special person when I met you. This is, and guys will be like, happy birthday, Jhatu. That's their whole contribution.
It's not even happy birthday. It won't even be happy birthday. It'll be kya kar rahe laudu. Like it'll be that.
It's the same thing, right? When if you were to talk to a female friend, you would actually have a conversation. Tu kabhi londo ko phone kar, hello? Kya hua? नहीं ऐसी कैसा
ऐसे
ऐसे फोन रात साला
कौन साला
नो सो द थिंग इज यू नो ऑफ लेट आई हैव बीन एबल टू हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ अ
कॉन्वर्सेशन
विद अ गाय फ्रेंड बट द प्रॉब्लम इज इट्स स्टिल वेरी इट टेक्स अ लॉट टू गेट टू दैट with a girlfriend you can get to that conversation immediately. You can pick up the phone and say, I have a problem. With a guy, if you have to either start to drink alcohol to get to a level, you can have that conversation.
You know something? I'd actually ask a female friend of mine, what is the difference between what do you get as a guy being friends with a girl and what does a girl get being friends with a guy? And her answer was great. She says, guys get to be vulnerable and women get to avoid
100%. 100%. That is bang on. Because I've been very emotional, vulnerable with or cried with my girlfriends as opposed to with my guy friends.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, yeah, if there's a big tragedy, I'll cry in front of anybody. I don't care. But otherwise, you're slightly more emotional, more softer when you are. And again, it's not. I'm not trying to make it a gender stereotype. It's just, it's better. You know, it's better to have that emotional conversation because you get that much back from the girl.
What do you mean by she gets to avoid drama? What does that mean?
Her whole thing was that she, like, you can just chill without having to, apparently, like, and we should have had a woman on this to comment on this.
We should have a woman on every podcast, but now we can't help it.
So her point was that with female-female friendships, there's a lot of thinking that goes into the...
Every word, every decision.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously it'll be different for everybody. But what you're saying,
basically what Varun said, right? Like, guys don't ever ask you why. It's basically, why? You know, for example, like when Siddhi, so if, for example, if there's friends going through something in my life, right? And I'm on the phone with them and I'll get the basic, this thing of whatever their life is going through, right? And I'll tell Siddhi about it. And she'll be like, so why are they feeling like that or doing that? I'm like, I never thought to ask. And... and that's
there's a lot of these points that you end up getting where people are like, but how is he? Did you ask him how he is? I'm like, no, if he wants to tell me, he'll tell me.
That line that you just said, I have said it so many times.
Every
time se baat karo, are is XYZ okay? Yeah, it must be.
Can I just say this right now? 1 second. Can I just
wants to talk, he'll talk to me.
Exactly.
Correct. More importantly, this has happened with Adar less than 3 weeks ago and we've still not addressed it. I'm just saying, like, among the four of us, it's happened with Adar.
But to be fair, I called up Adar.
So did I, but we called up and then we were like, okay,
but after that, I haven't checked.
Follow up has not happened. No, that's what it is.
And the thing is,
apparently, the problem happens is like when you're with the guys and girls. Like, I've actually had a conversation with my girlfriend, and I'm like, I'm talking about my guy. It's like, aray, dude, uske family mein tragedy ho gayi, his grandfather passed away. Like, haan, theek hai. And then we're talking about stuff, and then she asks me, okay, so how's his father? What's his, I don't know. It's like, acha, so what's his father's name? I don't know. How many years has he been your friend?
11. 30.
Yeah, exactly, dude. You know, so
I know Kautuk's father's name just because it's a running joke between me and Kautuk. Because I say something, ye hoga tera baap, and Kautuk says, nahi, mera baap Ramesh. That is all Kautuk. Like, that's the only reason I know Kautuk's father.
And that is a joke that Kautuk has been cracking since school. It's not even.
Okay, so I think this is, sorry, Kautuk, you want to say something? You finish uske baad.
No, so yeah, so I was just saying that I have a friend, okay, and the whole basis of our friendship is the fact that we support the same football club. that's the depth of a male friendship, like, and it's
enough
sustainable friendship, and
yeah,
it's just like, yeah, Real Madrid ka score dekha, ha yaar bahut kharab khela, ha theek hai chal next Champions League, and this is it, this is the whole friendship, and it's great.
Okay, so I have talking about the depth of male friendship, and genuinely male friends are pretty, like, male friendships are, they're unidimensional, they don't have layers, and that's, I guess that's how it's supposed to be biologically and evolutionarily.
Can I tell you something? This is also like, so one of the things that I've noticed with all my female friends is they have more ex-best friends. Okay, way more ex-best friends.
Because like, they're so invested, no.
Exactly.
Because they're so invested. Like, so, the guys...
You know, when I understood the concept, I read this article about evolution. And it basically says that simple organisms survive longer, complex organisms survive less. Yeah. And that's literally what male and female friendships are like. And that's why they have...
Yeah, yeah. Because they're genuinely invested. And it's like, how could you betray me versus... For us, and we'll just go on with it. Also, because we don't even want the confrontation.
That's the thing. Boy, the guys want to avoid confrontation. But you know, the best way to find out...
And that's all wrong, by the way. It's seriously toxic masculinity.
Yeah, it's fuck all. And you shouldn't be like that. But you know, the best way to identify your closest friends, right? Is to open WhatsApp. And you'll see one group. That group's name will be... कॉलेज बेस्ट फ्रेंड, लेकिन वो कॉलेज बेस्ट फ्रेंड में से चार लोग तुम लोग स्कूल में गए थे, तुम्हारा बनेगा एक सेपरेट स्कूल बेस्ट फ्रेंड, उसमें से तुम लोग तीन लोग बिल्डिंग में रहते हो, तो बिल्डिंग दो लोग ट्यूशन में जाते, यू नो, सो इट लिटरली कीप्स वो एक बड़ा सौ लोग
परकोलेटिंग डाउन ऑल द वे डाउन टू,
और फिर तेरी गांड फटी ऑल द डाउन ऑल द वे डाउन ग्रुप में, गलत चीज तो नहीं है, यू नो, लाइक आई जस्ट वरीड, ओ फक, डिड आई से द राइट ग्रुप,
all groups except for rebels are on mute, so
yeah, yeah, so be careful where you say what.
Okay, so I have, because of this whole like depth conversation, I just want to know, as guy friends, how many people have helped you as wingmen, or have women been better wingmen for you?
Bro, women are always women better wingmen.
Better.
Women are always better. Anyway.
Guys are your best.
I think it works both ways. I think I've been a better wingman for my, like, the girls who are friends rather than then another girl helping the girl.
But you need a male female duo to make wing.
Yeah,
wing
it works. Wingman. Wing person.
You know, there are times when a guy friend has tried to be a wingman, or ye sale harami na ghuste hai, fir dikhta hai, yaar, she's gorgeous. Ek kaam kar, tu nikal. Hey, have you met me? You know, like, suddenly. But with a girl being your wing woman, it's great because they understand or will know at least a little bit better than what guys know about what women want.
अरे नो, इट्स नॉट इवन दैट डीप, इट्स बेसिकली वुमेन जस्ट गोइंग लाइक, ओ ओके, सो यू आर फ्रेंड्स विद एटलीस्ट वन वुमेन, सो यू नो हाउ टू डू, इट्स जस्ट अ गर्ल टेलिंग यू रादर देन,
या बेसिकली इट्स अ गर्ल सेइंग दैट ही इज नॉट टेरिबल, ही नोस हाउ, ही वॉशेस हिज हैंड्स बिफोर ही ईट्स हिज फूड, लाइक इट्स दैट, यू नो,
नो, इट्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक, यू नो, इफ योर गाय इज बीइंग अ विंगमैन, राइट, अ गर्ल डजंट हैव टू डील विद जस्ट वन क्रीप, इट्स टू. So that's the fucking problem. It's just mathematics. That's one creep less.
Okay. So, yeah, like, I mean, yeah.
But, you know, there's also different kinds of friends, right? Friends you meet regularly, friends you hang out with. And in today's day and age, a lot of friends that you make online, right? That's another thing. How many, online friends, like, apne fans, people who follow our podcast, right?
Are you trying to get to Giridhar?
Yeah. Like, no, everybody watching the podcast regularly, like, there are some people, because we read all your comments, by the way, guys.
Yeah, so
I know some
people. हमारे WhatsApp group पे खाली तुम लोग के comments के screenshot
होते हैं. हाँ, तो करो comment करो भर के. But so that is also like a weird, like a different form of
like when Giridhar had stopped commenting for a bit, people were worried about Giridhar.
Yeah. I was worried. मतलब किधर है Giridhar, comment नहीं कर रहा है. You know, so that way, because a lot of people, if you've seen the comments that we've gotten, right, they also say stuff like, you know, like, we watch your podcast so much, or have been for so long, that they kind of feel we are also friends, you know, because literally the same thing is happening. You're knowing everything about our life, random, interesting, shocking, weird, absurd stories, personal stories, jo mere actual shayad doston ko malum nahi hoga. I have said on this podcast, and we all have, right? So the guys watching it also, to a certain extent, they start relating to you as a friend who you don't meet, but you meet every Tuesday.
This is actually a fact. According to a 2015 survey, like 29% people are just saying like it's all fake friends online and stuff. But the statistic shows that 29% people made 5 new friends online, which were actual like legit friendships, not just rando.
I got married to someone I met online. So I believe this.
Okay, and 38, another really fun statistic with about boys, teenage boys, 38% of teenage boys say that sharing their gaming handle proves
is one of the top things.
That means they're good friends. Okay, agar main tera apna gaming console tere saath share kar raha hu, that means I'm good friends with you.
So, you know, now that we're talking about the fact that people who watch this podcast are also like almost our friends, right? Friends we meet every Tuesday, friends who know everything about us. And as part of being friends, did I get stuck again?
Yeah, no.
So then what the fuck are you laughing?
Because we know where you're going, Varun.
Yeah, no, so don't laugh. Yeah. I keep thinking that. Okay. Anyway, the point is, you know, guys who've been watching our podcast and girls who've been watching our podcast, you guys are all our friends. And one part of friendship is that you listen to your friends. So you guys have been telling us a lot of things for very long. And as good friends, we have decided to finally listen to you. And we have for you a special surprise. So go listen to what this special friend that we have called on has to say to you guys and come back.
Hi guys, and a big, big shout out to Giridhar. So, Giridhar, you have actually managed to get Kriti Sanil on podcast, but I'm not going to discuss nepotism. To be honest, I have discussed that topic way too many times, and it has been spoken about too many times. What I really want to discuss is something which is more relevant, which is staying at home. I just want to request all of you watching this to please stay at home, follow the orders of the lockdown, follow social distancing. It is really, really important. And even when the lockdown is lifted, just make sure you still maintain the social distancing. Don't go berserk and go partying. Still wear the masks, wear gloves. Whoever you meet limited number of people only if it's necessary. Make sure you're still maintaining that 6 feet distance from those people. And don't step out even then until and unless it is really necessary. Because to be very honest, this situation is not going to get better if we don't act responsibly. So stay at home, watch the TIS episodes that completely will entertain you, and stay safe.
Yes, yeah. Finally, finally, after 3 years of
madness,
we did manage to get Kriti on the podcast, and really sweet of her to do it. So thank you so much, Kriti.
Thank you.
Guys, this is the power of a comment, one comment, yeah. And resilience of a comment. And
yeah.
Giridhar, please remember she mentioned you by name and none of us was mentioned by name.
Giridhar will be doing the Joey dance
We were reduced to an abbreviation.
Yeah. And it wasn't JJWS.
No, but you know, like, I'm really glad that she came. And guys, do not forget what she said, because what she said was very, very important. Yeah. Lockdown has been lifted, partially lifted, whatever. But
yeah,
like what she said, please make sure that you all are taking care. Don't jump around, go partying, as she said. Mm. Listen to what she has said if you're not listening to us. But it's really nice of her to do it, man. I'm actually really quite happy that suddenly podcasting, we've gotten Kriti, somebody we've been wanting to get for very long. And hopefully once the lockdown is done, we will actually get her to do a proper podcast with us.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
for now, you guys should be happy with at least this much. Yeah. She came, Giridhar.
We are so happy.
We are ecstatic that Kriti came.
Also, there's that Instagram handle can finally stop posting.
No, I can't believe it, bro. So many years of Giridhar's comment, that because Giridhar becoming pretty much the fifth member of our podcast.
Yeah.
Getting 1,000 likes for his comment. Like, it's insane. A new Facebook page which has 150 posts of wanting to get Kriti on the podcast. So the person who runs that Facebook account and Instagram account and Giridhar, we've tried our best to give you guys what you wanted.
Yeah.
Because y'all are our friends. So, dosti.
And guys, just remember,
sorry, there's no thank you. So
yeah. Also, yeah. I just want to say, guys, only my real friends are allowed to call me Baba.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh. Baba, you know this is not going to work, right?
Yeah, I know. People have entered. Yeah. People think that they've entered your nucleus and now they're going to stay there. Okay.
Yeah.
No, but
one
more thing I wanted to do. Now that Kriti has finally come, please go tell her thank you. Everybody watching this podcast, say Kriti OP on her Instagram. Tell her thank you.
Just go to Kriti and just flood her. Take a picture of the podcast that you're watching with Kriti on it. Go back on the timeline, take that picture and say thank you, Kriti, and tag her. That's what you can do.
Oh, yeah. Just comment there saying Baba sent me here.
No, but seriously, on a very serious note, Kriti, if you're watching this, thank you so much for doing this. We really appreciate you taking time out and sending us this very important video. Both educational and important for what we should do after the lockdown and in general fan service. So thank you. We are quite elated that you showed up on our podcast.
And what's also great is Varun has said, Kriti, if you are watching this, I mean,
I'll send her a link. Na. Hopefully she'll watch.
Yeah.
Do you guys feel like there is a weight lifted? Is this an end? Like,
no, you know what I feel is going to happen? What I feel is going to happen?
Giridhar's lost all purpose. Giridhar has lost all purpose.
Giridhar is going to find somebody else.
No, you know what's going to happen?
Giridhar, Angelina Jolie Scarlett Johansson.
No, so what's going to happen is someone is going to try for the next 3 years. And eventually, 3 years later, we'll get Elon Musk on the podcast. That's 100% certain.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's it from this episode
of The Internet Said So. We were discussing Friends. Let us know if you have any random, interesting, shocking, weird, funny stories with your friends in the comment section. But more importantly, go say thank you to Kriti. And we will see you guys again next week. Till then, it's all of us saying goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Hold up.
Thank you, Kriti. Thank you.
We could have done fan service facts, man.
No, but it's awesome, bro. I'm actually quite happy to see her at least show up even for a minute. So it's really nice.